on, everybody? It is Monday at like 6 o'clock in the morning in Pennsylvania, looking at like a temperature of like 40 degrees outside. So I'm going to be attempting to record my day. I don't know how easy that's going to be, but I figure why not give it a shot. So by getting some reports together, usually the first thing that I do. Morning starts off, alarm goes off every day about 5 o'clock. I hate being late, so I think that's why I don't really sleep that well at all, because in the back of my head I just keep thinking I'm gonna be late somewhere. So I pour us some coffee. Then we have our other smaller dog. So what I do then is I'll actually start cooking my breakfast. First, I'll eat about 4 to 5 eggs, depending on how I feel. Again, me eating that early in the morning, around 5:30, is really not the easiest thing in the world for me. Which I'll show you guys at some point, maybe on a weekend, that way my wife doesn't have to worry about, you know, being up and in the camera's face. And then I start prepping my lunch for the day. My lunch, for the day, which I'll show you my actual prep in the video. All it is just a salad, half a head of iceberg lettuce for the salad. So I'll chop that, about 6 ounces of, in this case, barbecue chicken, shredded basically, and we got some cucumber and onion and green pepper in there today, along with some ranch dressing, light ranch dressing. I have 2 shakers with me on a daily basis. First shaker is filled with basically a meal replacement, because again, eating all day can be somewhat hard. So, all right, the time is 6:40. I am pulling up to work now. So I'll be doing my reports that I gotta do, getting things together for my day, and then I'll be heading out probably around 7:30, 8 o'clock. Today I gotta drive to New London, Pennsylvania, which is sort of out by like, it's out there, it's kind of a drive. It's like going to like Avondale. So I'll be heading out there once I get settled here, getting things together for that. And then I'll kind of let you guys know what I do or what my day consists of once I leave the office. All right, it's 9:20. I have my first stop. I'll be here for like 2 hours or so. It's a Sunoco gas station on New London Road in probably Landenburg, I guess it's called. So I'm gonna do this. I'll be like in the store for 2 hours, arranging bottles, bringing in new products, and then I'll communicate with the sales rep on what the rep has to bring in for the day, for the order. And basically what happens next is we have a team, a reset team, that'll come out and basically put my vision to work. All right, so that's attractive, right? All right, so it is now 11 o'clock on Monday. I am getting ready to leave the account that I was at for like the past, I don't know, what was that like? Got here like 9:30, so roughly 2.5 hours, which could happen or might not happen. happen. The one thing too is on the road, it's sometimes I get calls throughout the day. Again, I'm is that better? Is that better? I'm a one-man team, so I'll get calls throughout the day with questions from sales rep. You know, if you can sell, that's awesome, but if you can learn how to sell in different formats, so yeah, you have to know how to sell across the board. Talking to people, talking, you know, customers that we work with, these independent accounts, they're getting sold every single day. So it's, you have to take a different approach also. You know, they're dealing with vendors all the time. So what separates you from everybody else that you're working with or competing against in that case? We're in most of Delaware down to about Middletown, Delaware. I'm covering in Pennsylvania, about to Philadelphia Airport, a little bit inside Philly, all the way up to Exton area, out to like downtown and Coatesville, and then actually also covering into New Jersey as well, going down, kind of crossing over the bridge, hitting like Penns Grove, Powell's Grove, or as what I call the Hills Have Eyes area of Jersey. So again, spend a lot of my day in the car, on the phone. I might take this time because in case he calls me back and I have to go in and change something, I'm probably going to take this time. I'm going to eat my lunch before I go to my next stop, which will be fairly simple. Going into an account, I'm going to see if they want to sign up with us or not. My job is to convince them, and not really convince them, but show them the benefits of doing business directly with us, as opposed to going somewhere else. Relax here for a little bit, listen to some music, eat my lunch. All right, so it is about, it's all going on the 1:30. Take a stop along the way because.
Turn right on South Springfield Road.
Thank you. It is almost time for my next quote-unquote meal, which is going to be another protein shake. So I grabbed some 2% milk, and I'm going to be trying an NO booster today for my workout, made by the same company that is that makes Mr. Hyde. So NO3 Drive is what it's called, so I'll definitely let you guys know what I think of that product. Now, if you have an NO booster that you recommend, also let me know what it is, because, you know, I never really dabbled. I love that word, by the way. I never really dabbled with NO booster, so I'm willing to give it a shot. Tag them and bag them. Get them signed up. Get them moving on a Pepsi program. And then I'll go and continue my day. So we'll see how it goes when I pull up there. All right, so leaving that possible new account, it was actually shut down, which made me think of, if anyone's ever seen the movie Glenn Ross, he's like, these are bad leads. That's what I just thought of. So I literally just drove, I don't know, 30 miles maybe. But they're not always going to be winners, and that's kind of the thing to understand. Sometimes you get leads that are bad, or they're old, or, you know, I say there's always a difference between an old lead, a cold lead, and a dead lead. So that lead was completely dead because it was shut down completely. They had like paper on the windows, but yeah, if you haven't seen Glenn Ross, and you're in sales, you should definitely check that out, because that's a good movie. It's funny, there's actually a lot of movies I like to watch that get me, like, in a selling mood, so to speak. And I only say it because a lot of times in sales, you your job can get to you, because no one likes getting rejected. And that's pretty much your job, is to get rejected, handle it, and then move forward. And it's always, you just always have to keep moving forward. So that's kind of it's kind of the story of sales, but it's always entertaining. I think my favorite movies are, Wolf of Wall Street is a good one. It's always a good one. Glenn Ross. And if you haven't seen Boiler Room, I suggest you go check that one out also. That one will have you very motivated. Pursuit of Happiness. I mean, it's not, you don't really see a whole lot of like sales parts of that, but I mean, I think that can kind of be, give you an idea of your day. Because no one closes 100% of the sales that are open. Unfortunately, that's just kind of how that works. You know, anyone who's in sales has gotten sold, technically. Someone sold you on the fact that you can make, you know, you'll be the next millionaire. I mean, there's jobs out there that are possible. Well, not to be a millionaire, but I mean, you can definitely make a very cushy living in sales. Depending on what you're selling, I mean, I've sold cars, I've sold all kinds of shit, medical devices, but at the end of the day, if you're not happy with what you're selling, then there's really no sense in selling it, because you're just going to be miserable every fucking day. You're going to be, you know, when it's time to clock in, you're going to be praying for that clock out. So, in sales, you gotta kind of be all over the place. You have to be able to get told no 5 times in a row and go to the next customer like you didn't get told no all day. Like, you are the reason that you do business with you is because you've just closed everybody else. So, that's always an important thing. And I think watching those movies or movies like that, where people are just like killing it out there, or they had a struggle or something like that, I think it's motivating to me, because you get to see all sides of it. You know, I've had my highs, I've had my lows. I always call it your ramen noodle days and your steak days. And then you can, you know, if you can survive in sales, you just take what you know from sales and just take it with you wherever you go. Because you'll learn a lot of great things in sales, dealing with people, dealing with issues, especially if you're a sales manager, I think it's one of the best managers to be, because you're going to deal with about 50 different personalities, and within the day, you're going to deal with one person having 3 different personalities. So it's definitely, but I enjoy what I do, I will say that, I enjoy selling. It's the thrill of the hunt for me, actually. I've also had the opportunity to, like, train people also in sales, which is... It's kind of cool when others recognize that you do know what you're doing, and you're not just talking, because, shit, half time in sales, that's all you're doing is just talking. Telling stories, you know, solving issues. But it's kind of cool because you get to pass on, I mean, things that took me years to grasp. I wasn't always a good salesperson, but things that took me years to get and gain that knowledge, I now get to pass on to someone, and I hope that anyone that I've trained, I wish them success, no matter whether they stay with the company, whether they go, you know, whatever they decide to do, I hope that they take what I've taught them. And just like I say, when I'm working out and doing the supplement reviews, like, this is what works for me. You never make it your own. So whether it's working out advice, nutrition advice, supplement advice, or even the sales advice, if you don't take ownership of what I put there and make it your own and call it yours, you know, put your little spin on it, and it's just gonna sound, you know, it's just gonna sound kind of like rehearsed, you know. And you know, that's the one thing you never want. You never want, especially in sales, you never want it to sound rehearsed or scripted, because you will scare people away from doing business with you. So, but again, that's just my two cents. If all you're doing is following in the footsteps of others, then you're only going to go as far as they went. You know, their business model looks great, or the way they did things looks great, but you could be more successful than me by, you know, taking it to the next step. Just get your own mark in the world. So that's kind of my advice after that. I just thought it was funny because, you know, I'm not going to sit here and say, I've closed everything that I've ever gone to. That's impossible, but pulling up to the next stop, and this one has been sort of giving me some issues because I keep having to revisit and go back, because they don't have everything that they need in order to set up an account legally. So I want to go back and see if I can get them, see if they have the information I need. But I will, alright guys, so that was a bust, another one. I'll just come back tomorrow, hopefully finalize that, and so now I'm on to my next meal, which is another protein shake, and I also have in there, some, glutamine also. So I'll take this. This is another meal of mine. Alright, so shake that up, drink that, and next time I talk to you guys, I will probably be home. I'm gonna finish up a few things out here in the field, and then I will go home, and we'll get ready to work out. I just walked in the door, so what I typically do now is I'm gonna make my pre-workout concoction. I also took my NO drive now. Gonna make my pre-workout, which consists of Creakong and Mr. Hyde. So I make that. I got my dogs that I've got to take outside, make sure they go to the bathroom, get changed. By that time, I'll probably be ready. And then I will go down and start my workout and get moving on that. Alright, so now time to work out. I already had my pre-workout, took my NO booster, and getting ready to begin the new schedule. So as you know, it's important to switch up your workout. It's very common for your muscles to get used to doing certain exercises. And kind of get accustomed to that. Oh, by the way, rocking my Primal Nutrition shirt today. Chest, we're gonna do chest, shoulders, and abs, as opposed to doing chest, back, and legs. Because that is kind of a huge load. Going with a higher rep scheme also. But we're going to basically make sure that we're hitting all points of the chest today. So incline, decline, do some flies, shoulders, we're going to do military press, shoulder flies, lat raises, end with some crunches, and then some hyperextensions or Roman chair, whatever you want to call it, and then finalize everything with some cardio at the end. So new workout. I can leave in the description. That way, if you guys want to follow along or give it a shot, you have everything there to do. Alright guys, so it's going on to, I think, like 5 o'clock. I'm coming to an end. I'm on a cardio right now. So I'll do this for like 30 minutes after the workout. Which the new workout was fucking brutal.
I don't know if you can actually see, but it was not fun at all. So I'll go upstairs, have dinner, and then I'll probably have about 40 minutes, and then my father-in-law is going to come over, and because he wants to get back into working out, so he's going to come over. I'm going to train him. I think I may have mentioned it before, but I'm going to do a little assessment to gauge his level. Also to see if there's anything that might be concerning, in previous injuries, medication, stuff like that. But we're gonna go into there. I want to keep it pretty easy for him today. He's coming 2 days a week, starting today. So I'm gonna do chest, probably chest and back with him today. And then I will, once my cardio is done, I'm gonna go up, I'll make my post-workout shake, which, if you've been watching, you know it's, whey protein, a, super carb from Nutribio, and glutamine from Nutribio also. You know, basically gotta refuel and, feed the muscles, especially after a workout like today. So, hope you guys are enjoying this so far. Hopefully it's exciting enough for you to, if you made it this far, you're awesome. If not, well, then you can't see that I think you're stupid, and I hope you fail at everything in your life. So, no hard feelings. No, I don't really care. If you haven't watched it, I don't know if my attention span would have made it this far in watching a video, so I don't blame you. Below, where you put your comments of how great my videos are and how much you wish you were my neighbor and stuff like that, I'll put in the workout that I did, so if you want to give it a shot. And then I'm gonna finish up here, I'll head upstairs, I'll start recording again, we'll have a whole bunch of fun, sweating our asses off, and
something in my eye. Ow. That's attractive. Whew. Okay. So, getting ready for tomorrow. Prepping my meals. I got my shake shit there. My vitamins there. Hope you guys enjoyed the video of my day. I will see you guys later.